from Wellesby Roots. Today we're going to be working on a project that I've been wanting to get to for quite some time. We're going to be making a waterproof tarp, and we're going to be making it out of bed sheets. So I was down in town the other day, and I stopped into the Salvation Army, and or Sally Ann, or U Store, whatever you want to call it, and I picked up some king size bed sheets. This one's came with a flat bed sheet and then a fitted bed sheet, and so we'll be using the flat bed sheet for the tarp, and then we'll be cutting up the fitted bed sheet for the other parts that we need. Okay. I chose this color. It wasn't a ton of options, but I kind of liked it. It's a kind of a greenish blue, so I think it should come out pretty good. So anyway, without further ado, let's get started. All right, guys, so here's the bed sheet that we'll be using, and the great thing about it is that as you can see here is that the edges are already hemmed, so I don't have to worry about doing that. So that's it's one step gone. So it's a king size bed sheet. It's fairly large, and it's gonna be lightweight because of how large it is, or because it's made out of a bed sheet. This is gonna work really well. So I'll show you that later. Main part of the project, and this is what they call the fitted sheet. It's the sheet on your bed that has the elastic corners. Okay. That's not important, but we're going to be using the fitted sheet to make the tie-outs. So, we'll get to that. Now, I'm not going to try and explain to you how I'm going to make my tie-outs, but I'm going to show you how I'm going to make them. So, the tie-outs, you can basically come up with your own ideas. There's a million ways to do them. So this is just how I'm going to do my tie-outs on my sheet. So my tie-outs are going to go, if this was my tarp, my tie-outs are going to attach to my tarp like this. One side is going to get attached to the tarp on this side, and then the other side will be attached like this, and I'm going to have about half an inch overlapping, and that's where the line will go through. So what I've done is I've taken the length, which was 98 inches, I divided it by 4, which works out to 24.5, so 24.5, which includes the corners. Okay, so I'm going to put tie-outs in the corners, and then 2 tie-outs on the length of the tarp. And then on the width of the tarp, that's 88 inches. Again, I divided that by 4, and then so I'll have 2, and then the 2 on the outer side. So I need 12 in total to go all the way around the tarp, and that should be good. All right, so all my guy outs are cut, and what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to iron them because it will make things easier for me later on. So I'm just going to iron them so that they're straight. And then what I'm going to be using for it I'm going to be using my iron-on. This is just a... it's almost like plastic. And it basically melts in between the material and basically welds itself together, or welds the material together. It's pretty simple stuff to use, and it makes the material a little bit tougher. You can buy this at Walmart, you can buy it at Michael's, any place basically that sells sewing type of material, any type of arts and crafts store, I should say. Sorry, I was focused on what I was doing and not what I was saying. So any type of craft store, you can buy this stuff at, and it's just, it's called iron-on. Basically, you just put it between the material and iron it. It's kind of a lazy way of doing things. If you have a sewing machine, which I actually do and know how to use, you can use your sewing machine. But I just find that this kind of makes the material a little bit tougher, and basically does the same thing. It's not glue. It's not like glue. It actually melts and melts into the fabric. and kind of welds it together, like I said. So there you have it. That one's done. Next. Alright, so now that we got all our tie-outs ironed into place, they're all pretty solid, they've cooled down. We're just going to put a stitch across each one of them. I'm just going to stitch them across here, just to help reinforce it, make it a little stronger. Alright guys, all my tie-outs are on. They're all pretty solid. So the only thing left to do now is go out and waterproof this puppy. Let's go do that. Alright guys, so once you have your tarp finished, all your tabs are all sewn into place, then you can get to water sealing it. Now I just want to mention that, like, this is a This bed sheet is 100% polyester, and so what I'm going to be using today is silicone and mineral spirits instead of the linseed oil. All right, so I'm going to be replacing the linseed oil with 100% silicone, and the reason for that is that the material won't absorb the linseed oil, so the material won't absorb the linseed oil, the polyester won't absorb it. If this was 100% cotton, then it'd be no problem whatsoever. It would wick up the linseed oil and absorb all through it.
The other thing I want to mention is that the iron-on that I use is great for 90% of sewing applications. It melts between the fabrics and basically welds the fabric together. But the issue with it is it's great for holding the tabs on until you can stitch them and everything's in place. You don't have to, you know, try and hold your material and stitch at the same time. You can stitch it all, you know, stitch it all up and the material is solid. But the mineral spirits will absorb or will erode the iron-on, and if you don't stitch your tabs on, then they'll fall off. So you need to stitch them. That's important. I want to stress that. This process that we're going to be doing today with the 100% silicone is also great for if you wanted to waterproof like a bag or a pair of shoes or anything, basically. A pair of pants, if you wanted to waterproof a pair of pants. Anything you wanted to waterproof, any material, it's great for it. So it's today we're going to be using, like I said, 100% silicone. I'm going to be using this whole tube. It's a waterproof sealant, 35-year durability, won't mold or anything else of the sort. This is 300 milliliters. This is just a local brand from Home Hardware. So we're going to be using that today. And I'm going to empty out this entire container into my bucket. And then I'll be using my, what do I do with it? My mineral spirits. And this is 946 milliliters. And I'll be emptying this whole thing into the bucket. And basically what this is going to do is it's going to just break up the silicone. And so it won't be such a solid state. It will be more of a liquid state. And you need to really stir it up and make sure you get it to a real liquid state. And we're going to be taking the bed sheet. We're going to be putting it right into the bucket, submerging it, soaking it, making sure it's fully covered, and then we'll be hanging it from there. But if you were going to use this this method of waterproofing for, like I said, a bag or a pair of pants or a pair of shoes or whatever you choose to use it for, you can apply it with a paintbrush. So you just dip a paintbrush into the solution and just paint it on. So, but we're not going to be doing that because I want to get the entire tarp. I want to make sure that it's completely saturated in the solution. So, so just to go over it again, this isn't a cotton tarp. So if you wanted to use the other method, and at the end of this video, I'll post a video that I actually did use the linseed oil method. And if you want to use the linseed oil method, then you have to have 100% cotton bed sheet. So it's the only way. The cotton just absorbs it, and every thread just is saturated in it. So this is, like I said, this is polyester, and I don't know. We'll see how it turns out, and we'll see how it works. The other downfall of the polyester is the fact that more than likely, if I were to get a spark from the fire land on it, it's going to burn a little hole in it. It's not going to ignite. It's not going to turn into a flame, but it's going to melt and burn holes in it. But you'll find that with any silicone tarp that you buy, if you were to get sparks from the fire onto it, you're going to burn holes in your tarp. So I probably in the future will make another tarp, and this time it will be 100% cotton. And then I'll use the linseed oil method. And it's just that with the linseed oil method, it takes about a week, 2 weeks, depending on the weather, for it to fully cure. It takes quite a while. And you'll know it's fully cured because it won't be tacky to touch. And virtually all the smell will be gone. You shouldn't be able to smell the linseed oil, really. There might be just a slight faint, but it should be. Should be mostly gone once it's fully cured. So, yeah. So, I just want to stress the fact you need to sew on your tie outs. or your tabs, just to make sure that they stay in place, because the mineral spirits just erodes the iron on. Like I said, any other application where you're not using a chemical, the iron on is great. So it just melts and welds the material together. So, all right, enough talking. Let's get to it.
All right, first things first, let's get the mineral spirits in there.
The other thing I wanted to mention just briefly is that if you're going to get when you get the silicone, get the clear silicone. You can get silicone in different colors, but make sure you get the clear, the transparent silicone. Unless you want your tarp to turn out multicolored. So now I'm ready to put my tarp in my bucket. I want to submerge it and make sure that it's completely saturated. You want to make sure you put on a pair of gloves. The mineral spirits will dry out your hands, and plus it just won't make as much of a mess. So got my gloves on. I already used these gloves for another job. So anyway. Take your tarp and submerge it right in the bucket. So you just want to take your tarp and get in the bucket, work it around, make sure you get every bit of it. It's going to take you a few minutes, but you just want to make sure that you get every part of it completely saturated. My gloves are all slick. I can't get them on. Just make sure you really work it around. See, here's some dry parts. Pull them out. Well, there it is. Tarp's all coated and it's hanging up, drying. While it's hanging, if you do notice that there's any sections that you may have missed in the bucket, just take a paintbrush to it, scrape the bottom of the bucket and just kind of paint over that spot, and should be fine. So this will take about 24 hours to dry, and then after that we can test it. We'll see how it works. Well, guys, it's finally stopped raining enough for me to come out and record the end of this. It's been raining for almost 12 hours today, and you can see the tarp held up really well. The inside is completely dry. None of the water is getting through. You can see on the other side of me here where it's puddled up, the cloth is not absorbing the water at all. Like I said, it is as dry can be on the inside of the tarp. I couldn't be more impressed with it, especially after 12 hours. It was raining like crazy today, thunderstorms, so on and so forth. So the wind was just hitting this tarp with all it had. So, like I said, I'm pretty impressed with the way it turned out. You know, for the price of a used king-size bed sheet, and keep that in mind, it's a bed sheet, so this is a bed sheet. Any other circumstance, it would be soaking wet. So the price of a used king-size bed sheet, pay between, I think I paid $10 for the, it came with the fitted sheet, and then it came with the flat sheet. So it was $10 for that, and then it was like $5 for the mineral spirits, and then it was like $3 or $4 for the caulking. So you're looking at roughly around $20. And I was online today, and I was looking at some of the lightweight silicone tarps, and they were ranging around $150, $200. You know, so it's a significant savings. And like I said, you can use this process to waterproof your shoes, waterproof your bag, waterproof any material basically that you want, any type of cloth that you want to waterproof. So for me, it's a good option. I don't know how much the sheet weighs now. I'd have to weigh it, I guess, once I folded it up. So, but there you go. There's how to waterproof a king-size bed sheet for a lightweight tarp. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and like always, I hope you guys got something out of it. Comment, subscribe, share the video, and I'll catch you on the next one. Thanks, guys.